I looked down at my legs. They had gone black.
When Diane Dike's legs turn a bizarre and horrifying color, she's confronted with a shocking twist of fate. She may lose her legs or have to accept something even worse.
I was afraid I was doomed to suffer like this for the rest of my life. I was desperate to be put out of my pain.
Cryoglobulinemia is a blood disorder in which the body produces excessive amounts of defective antibodies called cryoglobulins. In healthy individuals, antibodies help fight bacteria and viruses. But in patients like Diane, dangerous amounts of the faulty antibodies are produced. Cryoglobulins can cluster together in blood vessels, blocking circulation and inflaming the vessel walls.
What's happening is that the blood, it turns into a sort of a semi-solid because the blood has difficulty getting back up the legs because the channels have been damaged. Cryoglobulinemia is relatively rare. We don't know why people like Diane develop this process. It's possible to have kidney failure or problems with circulation in the heart that might lead to heart attack or stroke. Progressive damage to the blood vessels can lead to either difficulty with walking or actual need for amputation.
Diane Dike embarked on this life's journey, as we all do, with many dreams and goals. She swam competitively and qualified for meets at the state and junior Olympic level and participated in every imaginable extracurricular activity during her high school years. After graduation, she married her childhood sweetheart and pursued her educational goals, culminating with a doctoral degree in human services and counsel and psychology. All the while, she worked many jobs simultaneously. She taught for 12 years, from special needs pre-kindergarten children all the way to the university level. She worked for McDonald's in public relations and for Cypress Gardens, where she transformed into Angel Belle Diane and sang before thousands nightly. In spite of Diane's years of suffering and sickness, her goal was always to live life to the fullest and help as many people as she could along the way. She even traveled on tour with some of the biggest names in Christianity as a prayer warrior and massage therapist. One morning, she fell to the floor upon getting out of bed and could not walk. Her feet and legs were swollen to twice their normal size. After 2.5 years of mysterious and intense suffering, she was diagnosed with a rare and debilitating blood disease called cryoglobulinemia. She was given no hope for cure, and prescription drugs only complicated her troubles. It affects every part of her body, weakening her organs and immune system so much that she has fallen prey to many other diseases and syndromes that work daily to steal the quality of her life. I often wake to her crying in the night. However, if you saw her during the day, you would never know how intensely she is suffering. She is an amazing woman with a can-do attitude. I know you will fall in love with her just like I did. It is with great pleasure that I introduce to you my lovely wife, Dr. Diane Dike.
It's only by God's grace that I'm here today, because there were several years when dying seemed like a better option than living. Although I suffered, with God's help, I believed I could overcome my challenges, but something was terribly wrong with my body, and it would soon put my faith to the test. In the beginning, I pushed everything and everyone away, and I lost all that was important to me. I want to tell you that if you find anything helpful about my story, then my life has not been in vain, because there's nothing special about me, just that God made only one of me. And it's my job to be the best me I can for His glory. Well, God made only one of you too, so don't hold back. Be the unique person He made you to be, using your gifts and challenges like only you can. Speaking of unique, this is Gracie, my service dog. She helps me to deal with the blood disease and other maladies. She has been my gift from God and an answer to prayer. She has many tasks of service. Some include alerting me before a flare-up. She has been trained to stay in the snuggly to help keep my blood flowing with her life-saving heat. She can retrieve things and bark for help and remind me daily of God's unconditional love. I rescued her, and she rescued me right back. We go everywhere together. We're a team. But Gracie was alerting me in the store, and she would not let it go until I got a scooter and sat down. Isn't that amazing? What a gift God has given me in this present darkness. At times, I feel like a terrible burden, and it's hard to see any purpose in living when I'm bedridden for weeks or months. Consequently, I can feel depressed, unworthy, and unnecessary, like I do not matter or have anything left to offer anyone. I continually read Jeremiah 29:11 and remind myself that God has a purpose and a plan even for my broken life. He is counting on me. When I help others, I feel the best. So I will continue to do so whenever, wherever I can, for as long as I'm able. I am learning to be thankful even for the pain, which keeps me on my knees. I may never understand why I've been stricken, but I still believe in miracles. Every day I wake up is one. I'm humbled when I must ask for help, when Paul has to carry me, or when I must use this chair. But Gracie is truly a lighthouse in this rough and stormy sea. She is a gift from God, and she gives me reasons to get up every day. And that is why I have written The Adventures of Gracie the Italian Greyhound. It's a heartwarming series of children's books that people of all ages will enjoy. They're educationally sound and about friendship, love, and teamwork. Early on, God put a passion in my heart to know Him. I have studied His Word and I believe in it with all my heart. Whether I get healed from this disease or not, He is God. His love amazes me. So I bless His holy name in any case. Carnell Mercia said, "We must not only give what we have, we must also give what we are." So here, I offer you a part of what I am, as I learn to truly live while I'm dying. One thing is for certain, we will all die. Being ready may help us truly live. I look forward to meeting you and hearing your story. Stay strong and courageous. Second Chance with Saving Grace is a 501c3 tax-deductible organization. It's Paul, Gracie, and Diane's dream to touch the hurting world with hope. By sending love kits that include Gracie babies, glow-in-the-dark wristbands, books, t-shirts, cuddle blankets, whatever we can do to encourage those who are hurting or in need in any way. Whether it's an infant in the hospital or a prisoner in the prison, we want to go and bring hope and encouragement. We also support rescue groups that work diligently to find animals good homes. With the love of Jesus, we go to the world and we share our message by educating, enriching, and encouraging. Second Chance with Saving Grace visits after-school programs with a message of friendship, love, and teamwork. We go to colleges, share in chapels and church services. We go to businesses and we train them on disability awareness and etiquette. Sharing Gracie's story is an honor, especially with the children who are in orphanages. It's a blessing to know that we're reading a story to them each night as they go to sleep, so they know that they're not alone in this world. Together, we can help give children a brighter tomorrow. Research has proven that reading difficulties and illiteracy contribute to school failure and dropouts, increasing absenteeism, juvenile delinquency, crime, teen pregnancy, drug use, and other problems that impact our communities. Studies have also shown one of the easiest ways to increase literacy is to read to children.
It is our goal to provide our book especially to at-risk children. Through the sale of our Gracie merchandise, you can help us do that, so Gracie and Diane can read to children every day.